No, acne is completely unrelated to gut health, and I want to share with you the German New Medicine perspective on how acne comes about and the things you need to do to get rid of acne. Because I've seen a lot of people try diets and get nowhere. I've seen a lot of people put the creams on their face and that sort of stuff and get absolutely nowhere. There's a very specific cause to acne. And it is actually an emotional cause. And you're gonna think I'm crazy, but guys, stick around for a second. It's only gonna take me a few minutes to explain this. So, you gotta realize that all the organs in our body developed for a very specific survival purpose. When we experience a conflict shock, a stressful event that catches us off guard, we interpret the event. And on a conscious and a subconscious level, this happens in a split second, and it decides which one of our organs that was developed for a survival purpose is going to best help us survive this stressful event in front of us. And so acne is actually part, it's not part of the epidermis, it's actually part of the corium skin. You have two types of skin. You have the epidermis, which is what we can see. And then you have the corium skin, which is the skin underneath your skin. And this skin developed for to defend against attacks. Like that's its purpose, to defend against attacks. So when we're conflict active, so when the attack is coming at us, and again, this could be something literal, like someone coming at you with a knife. But more oftentimes it's figurative, someone throwing words at your face. This is why a lot of teenagers get acne because they're fighting with their parents. People who generally have a lot of acne, they fight with a lot of people. It's like words being thrown at their face. And another way this acne can get worse, another thing that can turn on this conflict. It's two things. It's an attack conflict and it's a feeling soiled, a feeling dirty conflict. So if so someone could be attacked and so the acne doesn't come up. So the conflict active phase is cell proliferation. We're building extra skin cells to help protect us from this attack that we're experiencing. And then when the conflict gets resolved, we are getting rid of these extra skin cells. And so that's when we have the pus-filled pimples. That's a result of the bacteria break, just it's like taking out the trash. If you're gonna like remodel your house or something like that, it's gonna look good in the end, but we have like this trash. So the bacteria and the fungi that, when we're popping those pimples, that pus is that's the bacteria and fungi at work, removing the extra gut cells and then put and then fixing the damage. So that's actually what's going on. What makes acne stick around for a long time is constantly getting in fights with your parents, your spouse, your boss, whoever it is. And it doesn't have to be a fight. It's like you can feel attacked. So for example, I still get minor acne, and I think it's from, feeling attacked by certain negative YouTube comments. I'm working on this. Remember, it's all about changing our perspective. When you get a pimple, instead of going, "Oh man, this is so gross," because again, that's going to make the program turn on again, or a chance that it could, because you're feeling soiled, you're feeling dirty. But when you see acne, just pop it and go, "Oh, great. I resolved an attack conflict. I resolved a feeling soiled conflict." And then, try to figure out what it was. And so we can change our behavior, change our reaction, to these certain scenarios that we are feeling attacked from. This is how we need to look, or feeling dirty. Another thing we can do is a lot of us blame it on food. I remember when I was little, I blamed dairy, I blamed chocolate and soda and a few other different types of food for my acne. And if that happens for long enough, those foods can activate the acne, because it's like, "Oh, last time we saw this food, we felt attacked." These things were in our consciousness last time this program became active. Okay, so it's a defense mechanism. Like if someone beats their dog with a newspaper, every time that dog sees a newspaper, they're gonna freak out. And our brain is essentially doing the same thing. We have PTSD from post-traumatic stress syndrome from, you know, food, from milk or something. Oh man, last time I had milk, oh man, we were being attacked. So essentially what you need to do is every time you get acne, congratulate yourself. I resolved an attack conflict. I resolved a feeling soiled conflict. Pop it or whatever. And then just say, wow, okay, great. I'm in the healing phase. And that's that. You can support yourself nutritionally by eating a lot of protein. But in the end, it's, you know, we're looking out for attack conflicts and feeling soiled conflicts. And again, these attacks can be in your head. They can be completely imagined. You know, like someone says something and you don't even respond back. And you're like, well, I felt attacked. That could be it. So guys, it's really that simple and straightforward. And if you have it really, really, really bad, you know, do not blame food. It is feeling attacked, and you probably feel, if you have really bad acne, you probably feel soiled. You probably feel dirtied from the acne. So it's changing your perspective. And you're already in the healing phase, so it's not like you got to resolve a conflict. It's just dealing with the tracks and the relapses. So guys, I hope this video helped you. If you have gut issues, I have an hour-long video that shows you everything, what I did step-by-step, and a few of my students did step-by-step to get better. It's going to be in the end screens at the end of this. And that's it. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.